Hi, we are Nat and Max, and we love exploring British Columbia. Recently, we've started off a camping series to learn our ways in the wilderness.
Is it clean?
Good luck!
But in this video, we'll be taking a short break from visiting BC's beautiful parks to go on a 6-hour private tour.
Oh my gosh! Are we going to ride this one?
And soar over the stunning backcountry mountains of Whistler, BC. Hey, good morning everyone, glad you can make it today. As you may have noticed in the title of this video, we are taking a short break from camping because it's our 5-year wedding anniversary. Now Max is in the shower right now, totally clueless on what's gonna happen today. Okay, maybe not totally clueless. I may have given her a bit of a heads up yesterday just to make sure that she wakes up early and gets dressed up. We just finished attending a virtual tour hosted by the DFA.
Over in Vancouver, Nat and Max, how are you?
Hey guys!
Oh, I love it, in unison!
That's why we got like the ring light over there, you got the laptop, and they sent us some treats over here. Put my camera over here. Because I need to tell you something.
Me?
Yes?
What me?
I'm gonna need you to wake up tomorrow at 7 o'clock.
PM.
AM.
No! Why?
We're going somewhere, and that's all the details that I'm gonna tell you.
What should I wear?
Clothes. Just maybe like your casual clothes, maybe good for photographs, some comfy shoes.
Okay. Jacket? Do I need a jacket?
Yeah, you need a jacket. No.
Sleeping bag?
Maybe just one jacket.
Maybe a tent?
That's all the details you're gonna get until tomorrow. Today, we are going on a 6-hour private tour around Whistler and Squamish. And I'll let you guys know more details later on, but right now, I'm just trying not to blow the surprise.
Are we going to ride here?
This is our ride today.
How are you, Nat?
Hey, how's it going?
Nice to meet you.
Elbow bump.
Hi Michelle, how are you?
I'm good, enterprise.
So are you guys ready?
We are, yeah.
Oh, it's going to be a surprise for you.
Oh my gosh, I'm scared.
All
right,
good one.
Thank you.
I have also face mask in case you need that and hand sanitizer. Okay, so the first clue, we're going to go to Squamish. And we're going to be exploring Squamish area and we're going to visit really unique places in Squamish. Have you been to Squamish before?
Yeah, a couple of times.
Gonna be, probably these places you haven't seen before, so yeah, it's going to be a good surprise for you.
Okay. Excited?
I'm nervous.
Keeps on telling me last night that we better not be going skydiving.
Oh. And swimming with the seals. Okay.
So our tour today is provided by Evergreen Adventures. So they do private tours here in and around Vancouver, and they do most of the time do door-to-door service. So they pick you up from your place and they drop you off there as well. They have full COVID protocols here. You got the plexiglass in place, you got all the face masks, you got hand sanitizers, you even have like a cooler. And this is headed by Jose Aspiri.
Yeah.
Did I say that right?
That's me, yes.
So his company does everything for you. All you gotta do is pick a package and everything is inclusive. We're currently trying to find some parking, but it seems that everyone is here in Shannon Falls today. So we're kind of parked here at Sea to Sky Gondola because the parking spot in Shannon Falls was kind of full and we're gonna hike our way to Shannon Falls. And being it's the perfect weather today, it's currently 23 degrees. Why not, right? New gondolas are coming along. Looking forward to seeing Sea to Sky again. I'll be in Wisconsin, where my childhood was
found. Red cedars, hemlocks, our beauties. Those are kind of the trees that we have around here.
Mm-hmm. 150 years, eh?
Oh yeah, some of them even more. The First Nation, the Squamish First Nation, they have this belief that about how Shannon Falls was formed. Mm-hmm. So the story goes like they said there was used to be two huge snakes living on top of the mountain, and they were coming down to the ocean, get some water, and then go back to the top of the mountain. So one day one of the snakes decided to come down, go into the ocean and never came back. Mm. So the other snake that stayed on the top was really sad and then started crying about
it. And that's why we have Shannon Falls.
It's crazy that we've been to Shannon Falls a lot of times, but this is the first time that we've done this.
Yeah, it's our first time doing a hike. Usually it's from the parking lot going to the falls.
Shannon Falls is considered to be the third tallest falls in British Columbia, going as high as 335 meters. It's about a 50-minute drive from downtown Vancouver and a 10-minute drive from the city of Squamish. It's clearly a pristine destination for anyone visiting the Sea to Sky corridor. But what we've learned recently is that it's also very popular to rock climbers, as Shannon Falls has some fantastic rock climbs.
I think this is the first time we've seen this spot empty. Usually there's a lot of people here taking pictures.
Just the appetizer of the entree.
Really? Oh, yeah.
There's still a main course. Oh. Any guesses?
Are we going parasailing or something? In the boat?
Nope.
Jet ski? Nope. Camping?
No, we don't have camping gear.
Yeah, I guess you'll find out when we get there. So Jose, how long is the drive to the next destination?
Be another 10-minute drive from here to the next destination.
Yeah, so not that far, right?
Not that far. Yeah.
Okay.
View than all the hikers that are hiking today without hiking.
Oh my gosh! I'm scared of heights. We're not skydiving, right? No skydiving. No bungee jumping.
I can't answer that.
No. Oh, paragliding! Oh my gosh!
What's that piece?
I saw something.
What?
Are we going on a heli tour?
Okay.
Okay, since we're here, surprise!
We're gonna see Garibaldi Lake, Garibaldi Mountain, and the Black Dusk, and all this beautiful area from the air.
Ready?
Oh my gosh!
Never been this close to a helicopter before.
A couple quick health check questions for all of you guys. Does anyone have a cough and a fever? Does anyone have a fever and breathing difficulties? A new question from Transport Canada. Does anyone think they have COVID-19?
No.
I don't know why that's not the first question, but there we go. And lastly, is anyone under a quarantine act means they shouldn't be outside?
No.
Nope.
Perfect. So yeah, like I said, I have everything that I need. If anyone needs a washroom, just across the way in the green building, washroom just right over there. I need about 2 minutes just to get into the computer. If you don't need a washroom, I'll meet you outside in the picnic tables in just a couple minutes and we'll go and have some fun.
Perfect.
Perfect.
Okay.
Thanks, guys.
Take it out. So come this way.
Restaurant or
we'll get into the back country and you're gonna see just these beautiful glaciers, the lake, the Garibaldi Lake from the air.
Mm.
And this time of the year is gonna be really cool because they might be parts of still ice.
With ice, yeah.
And then the blue, the beautiful blue coming out of the lake.
Love that.
Mm. So it's gonna be so good.
And plus it's so sunny today.
The weather is so nice. The
weather is so nice.
Are we going to ride this one?
I think it's that one.
In the front and in the back we have seatbelts just like you would have in a regular aircraft. So you just pop it in, lift up, undo it, tighten up as much as you need. We're all going to have a headset that we can wear. So it's a little bit quieter, we can all ooh and ah together and take pilot selfies, obviously. Mm. So a little microphone on the front. You don't need to press a button, you just speak into it. And if you can hear yourself, we can all hear each other. If you can't hear yourself, just move the microphone a little bit closer, speak a little bit louder, and we should be able to talk to each other. This plane has two doors. This is one. That's the other. If you forget how you got in, I'll remind you how to get out, which is pretty good. Getting in and out, little step here if you need it. Again, obviously, just watch your head there. throughout the flight, the door will be locked. So there's the door in the lock position. If you need to unlock it, that unlocks it. If you need to open it, that will open it. Obviously, we'll leave it locked throughout the flight, and I'll open up for you when we get back down. But in case you need to open it, it is that easy. On the ground here, we'll usually leave the window open. It's kind of hot today, so we'll just get this nice little bit of fresh air. But before we go flying, I'll just reach in and shut that window. A few elements of safety between the front two seats, we have a fire extinguisher. We plan on using it, that's where it is. Underneath this right rear seat, we do have a first aid kit and then also a survival kit in the back of the aircraft. We do have ashtrays, but there's no smoking, which is ridiculous enough to say. We do have some in-flight entertainment, forget how you got in, you can figure it out again. And last but not least, we do have doggy bags. I don't think we'll need them today, but hey, we have them in case we do.
Do you need one?
I don't know.
We have some Feel free to hop one in the back there. If you want to give yourself more leg room, you can feel free to pop that bag just in behind you.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I guess we're doing this.
Yeah, there you go.
This is the smallest plane that we've ridden so far. There are only four people. You can only fit four people here.
I can't hear you.
After a few safety checks, we were off to the runway. Surprisingly, the takeoff wasn't that bad. We didn't even realize that we were already off the ground until David said we were. And it was mostly because we were already so amused of the views.
This is a 50-minute flight over Whistler's backcountry mountains. The first few minutes of the flight was hovering over the city of Squamish and the neighboring areas as we navigate ourselves. It was quite amusing how all the greenery started getting snow as we flew further. And before we know it, we were already surrounded by snow-capped mountains. We got pretty close to a remnant of a stratovolcano called the Black Tusk. We've also saved over 10 hours of hiking time and saw the Garibaldi Lake. And it was also our first time seeing an actual avalanche.
Most of these mountains are hikeable in a way, but it will take you hours to get to the peak. If you look closer, you can see people hiking through snow to get to the summit. We like to think that we're pretty outgoing and have tried a few adventures here and there, but this flight made us realize that we've only begun to scratch the surface of what this place can offer, and we're lucky to call it home.
Cruising deep space in my motorhome.
We made it!
Land.
We made it back!
Perfect!
That was awesome! Any guesses where the next one is?
Somewhere with food.
She's getting hungry.
I'm always hungry.
So how long is the drive to the next stop?
That's going to be another probably half an hour back to where we are going to stop for lunch.
Mm-hmm.
So just hold your appetite.
Ah, okay.
So this plane ride was provided by Sea to Sky Air. And I think the most common misconception with this plane ride is it's very expensive, but in reality, you can get a small plane ride or a short plane ride for maybe about 10 minutes for as low as $56 plus tax. Yeah, and you get to see that amazing view that we just saw.
Yep.
After a quick half an hour drive, we've reached our final destination, White Cliff Park. So it looks like it's the same problem here at White Cliff Park as of Shannon Falls. Since the weather was so nice today, everyone is out and the parking lots are full. Since White Cliff Park was full, we had to go to Plan B and have our gourmet picnic lunch at Horseshoe Bay. You guys could see that this is a full service from Jose, setting up the picnic table, the picnic blankets.
Complete with flowers.
All the
So essentially, he made me choose if we wanted salmon, or we wanted pork, or we wanted like a veggie option.
Yeah.
I chose salmon first.
Yeah. Salmon is my favorite. Been given is a few simple minutes. I will give every one of them to you. After eating, we decided to visit White Cliff Park again and was lucky to get a parking spot. If you only knew. Yeah, but 360 view. Jose then showed us some of the best viewpoints in the park. With just a smile, change my whole
world. And just like that, we are back home. Thank you guys for celebrating with us today on our 5-year anniversary. And if you guys wanted to check out Evergreen Adventures, we are gonna link them down on the description down below.
I think Jose was the nicest person we've ever met.
Yeah, they even gave us a bunch of gifts. Them knowing it's our anniversary, they gave us like a bottle of wine.
And a box of presents.
What is that?
My favorite!
More cookies!
Their cookies are the best. I love them. I almost asked him for more. And now I have more!
I think that's why he gave me some cookies, because you said that they're perfect. They're terrific.
This is mine, don't eat it.
And yeah, I guess that's gonna be it. If you guys are new here, make sure to hit subscribe and give this video a thumbs up.
And we'll see you guys next time.
Bye! If all I've been given is a few